Hey guys, it's Loves to Loom here. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create this super awesome Coracle bracelet created by the_looming_corner on Instagram. He did such an awesome job on it. I love it. So this is a reversible design. I believe this is the signature side. That's the side he posted on Instagram. And then this is the back side, which I think is super cool. Technically, I think this is the front side, but I think this one is the signature side. So yeah, anyway, this is what this one looks like using some Persian, or maybe that's Egyptian, limited edition, just a mixture of some bands, and I think it looks awesome. So you can definitely use whatever type of band. This one is opaque. So I just want to forewarn you that it did take me almost 400 bands to create a full wrap. So be aware of that. And without rambling on and on, let's go ahead and get started. In order to make this bracelet, you will need to have a total of 7 bar pins. If you want a full wrap to go all the way around your wrist, you're going to need a total of 5 looms because you need 14 bar pins. Wow, I know that's a lot. I think this is literally the biggest loom setup I've ever made on camera. For the loom setup, you want to have your 3 middle bar pins in a normal loom setup, like so. And then your next 2 outside ones, you want to have them going in 1 more from the center. So it should be like a V. And then these 2 should be aligned. So I'll hold it up. Should be set up like so. Okay, so the first bands that we're going to lay are going to be the bottom row here, which is the border band or the perimeter band going up the side. So we're just going to lay the bottom for now. So grab whatever color you want to use for that border slash perimeter. And we're going to start by laying just 1 single band on the very middle for the closure. If you like a tighter close, then do 2 bands there. And now we're just going to go out to the left and to the right, just outlining the bottom. So from the center, go out to the right. You're going to go out to the right again, and then out to the right again, like so. And then we're going to do that same thing, but coming back to the left. So from the center, coming out to the left, coming out to the left again, and 1 more time. So the whole bottom should have that on there now. So now we're going to start, we're going to continue laying our border color, but we're going to alternate and also add in the color bands that are right here, this blue Egyptian. So I'm going to use limited edition bands for those ones, but I'm only going to work on the left side because it's easier to do one side at a time. So we're going to lay 1 more border color band going forward, like so. Now grab your second color, and we're going to lay that from this second pin from the end, going up diagonal out to the left, like so. We'll lay another forward band, and then we'll come up to this next pin and lay a diagonal band. And that's what we're going to continue doing. So we'll lay another border band going forward, come to the next pin, lay a diagonal band going out. And we're just going to continue that all the way up. So I really like this design a lot. Hope you guys like it as well. I know that it is quite a big loom. So when you have two empty pins down here at the end, that is actually where we have to bring it in order to close it properly. So from this last pin where we have bands, we're going to bring that border color band horizontally into the right. And then we'll continue going in to the center. Like so. So that one goes diagonal up and then up again. So then we're just going to come back to the beginning and we're going to do that again. On the right side. So we'll start with our forward band and then grab your other color, and that should connect from this bottom pin here, diagonal out to the right like so, and then forward, diagonal, forward, and diagonal. So just like you did on the left side. So I'm going to go ahead and just get this side laid out, and I'll meet you guys back here in a moment. So remember, when you reach the second to the last pin on this side, you're going to take your border color band and you're going to bring it horizontally into the left, and then we'll continue to go to the left until you reach that center so it should match up with the other side. So this is what it should be looking like right now. I should have probably used some darker colors. I never think of that. Ah, sorry guys. Now we are going to start laying some bands that lay horizontal across all the side pins. And that is going to be what is my opaque blue in there. You can see it from the side. So I'm going to use purple. I'm just going to do my left side first. So come up to the second row here. And you're just going to lay it straight across those two pins. Come up to the very next row and do the same thing. So this part is super easy. Of course, we're going to do this on both sides. So you do it all the way up except for the very first and last row. And you'll clearly see that because that's where the border bands already are. I'm moving slow because I'm working with my left hand. So that's my last one for my left side, and then you're going to do the same on the right. And for these bands, it doesn't matter if you start at the top or the bottom because they do not affect any other bands. So as you can see, I'm just going down the right side because I was already at the top of the loom. So I have finished laying all of my horizontal bands. It should look something like this all the way up. And now we can go ahead and lay a single chain up the center. So this part's easy as well. And this is going to be, well, it doesn't have to be the color of your border, but I'm using the same color as my border, and that's this right here, that single chain. So just starting on the center pin, we're just going to lay one in front of the other until you reach the top. So just a normal chain. I told myself before that I did not want to use this color silver in tutorials because I don't like how light it looks. Like it's kind of hard to see on camera, and yet I forgot. So I'm really sorry, guys, that I made that terrible mistake. But all the rest of the colors I'm using for this do pop out, so... After this part, you should be good to go. Okay. So I have now laid the whole center row. And now we're going to lay some more bands in the center. So push your bands down once again. And now we're going to start laying some center X's. And that is what is going to be the dark blue in this one. So running up here. So using my gemstones green, I'm going to start laying those X's. So starting on the bottom left here, connect it to the center. Do the same on the right, connect it to the center. And then we'll do the same, but going in the opposite direction. Going out to the left, going out to the right. So that's our first little X. We'll start on this pin here, coming in. Second pin coming in. And now we're going to do going out. And laying in this order, left, right, it just makes the looping a lot easier instead of doing one side at a time. So this is all we do the whole time, just connect everything to the center. Whoops. Making lots of X's. Okay, so I'm quite sure you guys know what I'm doing. So I'm going to go ahead and finish laying the last few rows of my X's, and I'll come back in just a moment and show you what to do next. Alrighty, so this is what it should look like now that I have all of my centers laid. So I've already pushed mine down. Take a moment to do that if you haven't already. And now we're going to start filling in these spaces right here. And that is what is the olive green and the white in here. So it's the white right there and the olive green is what we're going to lay right now. So whatever color band you lay first, which will be the band going diagonal out to the left, is going to be the olive green here. So I'm going to use white. And we're going to just come to this second pin and we're going to connect it up here diagonally out like so. And we're going to actually alternate. So now I'm going to grab my other color, which is going to be black. And we're going to cross it, kind of like a T, but it's on a slant, like so. Then we'll come up to where we ended on the black one and come out to the left. I couldn't think of the word. And then we'll cross it again, like so. So you always start where the last one ended. And then cross it. I know I'm like so quiet when I do these, but I really don't know what to talk about. Because it's kind of like straightforward. I mean, once you know what to do, you know what to do. So I don't want to like keep just babbling on for no reason, but yet I feel like sometimes I should be talking. But yeah. So I'm laying my last one for the left side. Like so. So it should look like that all the way down. And obviously, we have to come do the right side. It has like this purpley color. I don't like it. Okay, so come down here. Bottom right pin, and we'll do the same thing, except now my white is going to be going out to the right, like so, and then crossing my black in. So it's the same thing, except we're going in the opposite direction. Always starting where your last one ended, and then cross it. Starting there, going out, and then cross it. So I'm going to go ahead and get this side laid, and then I'll come back in just a moment, and I will show you what we're going to do next. We have one more layer after this. So once you have all of those laid, we're going to come back and lay just one more layer, super easy. We're actually going to just lay a single chain on rows 3 and 5. So straight up that. You do not see this a whole lot in the bracelet. I actually used opaque blue for that as well. But it's right there where my thumb is. So it's in there, but yeah, you don't really see it that much. So I'm going to use Caribbean green. And we're just going to make a single chain up those two rows. So I'm just going to do one row at a time. Just one in front of the other. I couldn't imagine using a loom bigger than this because I can barely fit it in the view of my camera with it being this big. So definitely kudos to anyone who does tutorials on a loom setup bigger than 7 bars wide. This must be challenging. So I've done my first row and now I'm going to come back and do my second row. Same thing, just on this row here. So I'm just going to get this one laid really quickly, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I have all of mine laid, so now we can turn our loom around, finally. So the arrows are now facing yourself. So now we're going to grab 5 of our border band colors so that we can lay cap bands. We're going to cap band all of the pins on the first row except for the last 2. So there should be 5 cap bands. So I'm going to do the first one here on the center. And these are all just regular cap bands. So wrapped around 2 times. So I did all that side. Don't do that last one. I'm going to do the same on this side. Like so. So now that we have all of our 5 cap bands on, we can finally start the looping process. So the first thing we're going to do is super easy. We're going to be just looping the top layer on rows 3 and 5. I'm going to work on the right one first. So we're just going to go in that cap band and grab that top band. Make sure you don't pull your cap band off. Just bring it forward. Continue grabbing the top band and grabbing it and going forward. We're just going to loop that straight up on both of the rows. So this part's definitely super easy. One of my favorite words to use, huh? Okay, so I'm going to just come back to the beginning so I can do the same thing on this row here. Going in my cap band, grabbing my top band, bringing it forward. Going in the next cap band that I just created, bringing that top band forward, and do the same thing that you just did. So I'm going to go ahead and just get this one looped up really quick to save on some filming time. And I'll be right back to show you the next step. So once you have both of those rows looped all the way up, come back down to the beginning. And now we're going to start looping these bands here that are like in a T. So we'll loop the bottoms first, bringing them back to themselves, and then we'll bring the cross band outwards. So I'm going to do my left side first. So counting from the center would be your third pin or your first one in from the left. Push back your cap band. Grab the top band, bring it back to itself, which will be inwards, diagonally inwards. And then we're going to come to this pin, which is where the first cross band is. And we're going to go in this cap band here, which is on the second pin. Grab the top band and bring it back to itself, which is out to the left. And then wherever you've ended, that same pin you'll go in. Grab that band, bring it back to itself. Then come back here, grab that top band, and bring that back to itself, which would be out. So we'll be just alternating back and forth. So bringing that diagonally in. Always have to come back one pin, grab the top band, bring that out. Go in the pin you've just looped, bring that out. No, I'm sorry, that should have went in, not out. That's what happens when you think and talk at the same time. So we're just going to keep alternating like this. I'm going to lay my loom back down. I'm going to turn it a little bit so my hand's not so much in your view. So as you know, you're just going to continue doing this all the way to the top. And then when you have reached your top, you're going to come back to the beginning and we'll do the same exact thing for the right side, except we'll be going in the opposite direction. So you would come down to the third pin from the center. You would go in your cat band and grab the top band. Bring it back to itself, which will be going inwards. And then we'll come back one pin, grab the top band. And you'll bring that outwards like so, so it'll cross over it. Go in that same pin you just looped, grab the top band, bring it back to itself, which will be diagonal in. And then we'll go back a pin, grab the top band, and cross it. Just like the other side. Just keep alternating all the way up. So as this does take a moment or two, I'm just going to go ahead off and get it finished up. And then I'll come back in a second and show you the next step. Alrighty, so it should be looking like this now. So we're going to come back to the beginning and now we're going to work on our middle X's here. So the first thing we're going to need to do, oh, and we're going to loop the bottom band that's on that middle row as well. So the first thing we're going to do is start on the center pin, and we're just going to grab the top band and bring it forward. Like that. And now we're going to come onto this left pin and bring this band in, and we'll do the same on the right, bringing that band in. So come here, push back the cat band, grab that top band, bring it into the center. Repeat the same thing on the right side. Bring it into the center. And now we have to bring the top two down into the center. So coming on my left, go in the cat band, grab the top band, bring it down, and repeat on the right side. So everything should be coming into the center. Let's move it down because it's going to be a little squished. And then we'll end that little section by going inside that pin where all the bands are on, push back everything, grab the very bottom band. And it should be the color of your border band or whatever color you decided to use. Mine's the same color. Bring it forward. And now we're going to start that all over again. So we'll come into the side pins, grab that band, bring it in on the right, like that. And then we'll bring these two down. So there's quite a few bands on these pins here. So just make sure you're pushing them all out of the way. Grabbing your X band and bringing it in. And then we'll go in, move everything out of the way, grab the bottom band, and bring it forward. So we'll come up to our next one, do the same thing. So you should be looping all four bands into the center. And then going in that same pin, grabbing the bottom band, and bring it forward. Just make sure you are getting through all the bands when you go inside to grab the bottom band. I've noticed when I was doing my example bracelet that I kept almost missing one of the bottom bands. So just make sure you are actually, in fact, pushing them all out of the way. line's really tight because of the limited edition bands. I mean, it's a little tight anyway, but I feel like the limited edition's definitely making it a lot tighter. Alrighty, so it should be looking like this right now. So now we're going to come back to the beginning and we are going to first loop out this bottom row. So we're going to go inside this front middle pin here. And we're just going to loop this bottom row out. So the top band goes out to the left. Go back in there, bring the next one out to the left. And then go in that one, grab the bottom band and bring that out to the left. And then we'll do the same thing on the right side. So grab the bottom, bring it out to the right. Push back those, grab the bottom, bring it out to the right again. And we'll do that one more time. Like so. So now we're going to work on one side at a time, and my loom is actually starting to like fold in a little bit, so yours is probably too depending on what bands you used, so just be careful if it is. So I'm going to come over to my left side here. We're going to alternate looping the border band forward, the horizontal band, and the diagonal band that I have in there. So we're actually going to come to the second pin, so it should be the second row and then the second pin up from the border. We're going to go inside the top layer of bands, grab your horizontal band, and bring it back to itself, which should be going out to the left. Go back in that same pin, grab the band that's left, and we're going to loop that diagonally down back to itself. So it should look like that. And now we're going to go inside that pin, push back the top bands, grab the bottom, which is your border band, and just bring that forward. So there's three steps to each little section. So now we'll come up to this next pin here, go inside those bands, grab your horizontal band, bring that out to the left, and don't pull too hard because it will pop this off. As you can see, mine almost did. Go back in that pin, grab that band, and bring it diagonally down to itself. And then you'll go inside that pin, push back all of the bands on top, and grab that very bottom band and bring it forward. And I'm sorry if I'm getting a little scratchy. It's getting kind of late here, so don't mind it. So again, coming up to the next one, starting off by looping my horizontal band out, grabbing the next band, bringing that down, which is back to itself. And then go in that pin, grab that bottom band, and loop that forward. That's such an odd angle, and I'm like so struggling to loop this. If anyone's actually watching this right now, which you're probably not because you're probably looping yourself, but I feel like so awkward right now. So I'm going to go ahead off camera and just get this looped up, and then I'll be back in a moment and I'll get you started on the right side. So when you do reach the top on this side, you're not going to have a horizontal band on this pin here. So you're just going to go straight in here, grab your diagonal band and bring it down like you were before with the diagonal bands, and then go in and loop the bottom band forward like that, and then you'll go in here and bring this bottom band over to the right, go inside that one and just keep going to the right, bringing it into the center like so. So now I'm going to come back to the beginning. So we're going to come down, we're going to come over to the second pin, or the second row, and then go up to the second pin, go inside your top band, grab your horizontal band, and this side will obviously go out to the right, go back inside that same pin, grab your diagonal band, and you're going to bring it down, back to itself. Then we'll go in, grab the bottom border band, and bring it forward. So we'll come up to the next one. Always starting looping that horizontal band out first. Bring the diagonal band down. Grab the bottom band, bring it forward. So I'll do a couple and then I'll go off camera. So it's just like the other side, except the other direction. So once you reach the top, make sure that you bring it in to match up to the center like you did on the left side. It should, you know, that border band up there. And then we're going to locate the band that we laid in the beginning. Push back inside all of the top bands on that top pin and grab that bottom part of the band. And we're going to bring those together and attach our C-clip. Alrighty guys, so when you do finally have it off of the loom, it may look very like curled up like this and kind of messy. So I'm just going to show you a couple tips how to fix it. The first thing that I do is the center on this side is very tucked in. So I first actually stretch it like this to try to get everything to fall into the natural place. And then I pull it this way so that the middle isn't so bunched together. So do your stretching, and then I go down the centers and I pull them out because they're really tucked in from pulling it off of the loom. So that's the second thing I do, and I do that all the way down. So you can see how they're really tucked there and nice there. Now for these side bands, you probably have a lot of them going in different directions. So I want them to lay going all down like that. So for the ones that's flipped up, I just grab the band and I roll it down with my finger. So this one's flipped up and I just roll it between my fingers and keep rolling down until it just goes in that down position. And I do that to any of them that are flipped up. And I just keep rolling down and it falls down nicely. So to close it up, we're just going to locate that C-clip, and you have a very visible cappy end here at the end. Just bring the two together, and voila! There you have the completed super awesome Coracle bracelet. This was created by the_looming_corner on Instagram. I'll have his link in the box below so you can check him out and give him a follow. I know he has more designs on Expert Looms channel, so you can check her out as well. Also, if you do make this, don't forget to tag both of us. I am Loves to Loom. He is the_looming_corner on Instagram. We'd love to see a rendition of it. Don't forget, guys, if you do like this design, hit that like button below. We'd greatly appreciate it. And I do appreciate you sticking around for another video, and I will see you soon at my next tutorial. Bye. Have a good night.